If you're looking to experiment with CNC, the 3018 is a great place to start. It's like the Ender 3 of CNC. So we'll take a look at a new one that's been released by SainSmart right here on CNC Sunday. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCB prototype the easy way with a full-featured custom printed circuit board prototype service from PCBWay. This video is also brought to you by my Patreon supporters. When I first launched my channel many years ago, I had three different segments of the channel. It was Filament Friday for 3D printing, I had CNC Sunday for CNC, and then I had Technical Tuesdays, which occasionally would pop up where I'd talk electronics or things like that. Well, I just ran out of time to do all that. And Filament Friday clearly was the most popular, so that's what I did. But I didn't stop doing CNC. I did, I don't know, about 20 CNC Sunday videos. And I focused on the X-Carve, which was my big CNC, which is off camera over here to the side, that I still do projects on from time to time. But my main interest in CNC was cutting circuit boards. And that's where this guy comes in. Now, I've since gotten a Bantam Tools PCB cutter, PCB mill. It's fantastic. There's no competing with it, but it's like a $2,500 machine. And I got a closeout unit, so it's cheaper than that. But this is what I wanted my 3018 for. So this particular unit I actually got from Banggood. It was a kit. It's about $180. I put it together and it wasn't perfect. This is actually like, composite material on the sides and the front. And when I tightened everything up, it just wouldn't move exactly right. And then I had to mount the motor on the side because the holes for mounting everything and the recessions, it was wrong. It was supposed to be on this side, but it would only fit when I assembled it this way. So it took me extra time to put this together. And the electronics that came with it were horrible. So I got better electronics, which are actually SainSmart sells these, the same one. But it's electronic, so I can control everything right from an SD card and this little controller. So I don't even have to hook up to a computer. I can do everything from an SD card, which I like to do. So I did cut some circuit boards on this. I've had some pretty good luck. Once I put a piece of wood and milled it perfectly flat, which is what you want for, you know, cutting circuit boards. And I've played with it, but I never really got perfect results. So I didn't do a lot with it for a while, and then SainSmart offered me this guy, which is their latest. Now, what I built here with all the pieces is essentially what SainSmart sells as their 3018 Pro. So this is the upgrade to that. This is the 3018 Pro VER. What that VER stands for, they just said that's the name they gave it. But it's got a lot more features, a lot of things that I wanted on this, such as a bigger display so I can it's easier to see, touch buttons, which are easier to use than these little buttons, but it still accepts an SD card right here at the top, so I can still run off that. But it's got stop switches at every point. This one I would run sometimes too far, jam into the motor, and it would, and could cause damage. This one, it stops. So that's a nice feature. This has also got better electronics than this. It's got opto-isolated drivers, so it can't kick back and destroy the electronics, which is a benefit. It also has a zero probe. So you clip this onto the bit and then put this down on the bed like this and then lower it down. And when it touches, it knows it's zero point. So little things like that have been very, very handy. But the biggest thing to me is that it's an all metal construction. All the sides are a solid aluminum and it comes almost fully assembled. The bottom half is all assembled. The top half is all fully assembled. So you just gotta put those two pieces together and then install the electronics, which really didn't take that long. So about an hour, I put about an hour into this thing and it was assembled and ready to go. This one, I swear I had 20 hours in this thing, taking it apart, putting it together, trying to get everything to work right. So this is definitely more expensive. This one I think is around $250 if you buy the SainSmart version of what I have. And this one's like around $350. For about $100 more, you're getting just a little better quality. It's kind of like a, you know, a Ender 3 versus Ender 3 Pro, or Ender 3 versus Ender 3 V2, something like that. But I've been really happy with this, and the base is a lot more level than what I was getting on here. I still put a piece of wood down to mill it for circuit boards, but I didn't have to mill as much as this one to get a nice smooth surface. And I'm getting actually really good results. I'm still working on some design flaws that I need to make my pads bigger, and because I'm drilling through some of the pads. So I haven't got the drilling totally sorted out yet, but I'm real close. But overall, I think it's a pretty good machine. Now, they do give you some sample files on the SD card for cutting out of wood. So if you just want to do some decorative cutting, it does a fine job of that. You can get a laser adapter to this for, I think it's about $100 more, so you can do laser etching with it. But to me, this is really a great place to start and still have a quality machine if you want to try and do CNC and also cut some circuit boards. And because you can run it standalone, you don't really have to hook up a computer, although there are advantages. And they do have free software you can download and use with it. There's not a lot of choices if you're a Mac user like me. It's mostly for PCs. And I don't really like having a computer tied up holding this thing, because if the computer goes to sleep, stops sending G-code, it could, you know, mess up the whole cut. And you kind of got to stay around this thing, because when it's cutting, like a 3D print, I can walk away because it's just adding material. Most I'll get is extra plastic floating around. This thing, you can actually drill into things if something goes wrong in the G-code. So I like to keep an eye on it. And so because of that, I really don't want a computer next to it. I like just doing it all standalone with an SD card. One other feature this has that this one doesn't is a stop switch, emergency stop switch. I hit that red button and it shuts power off, so everything stops. That is very handy. I've had times where this is starting to cut because I did something wrong in the setup and I had to quickly like reach back here and find the off switch. This thing, boom, slap that button, everything stops. Once I get my prototype cut out, proven, then I'm ready to go to production. And for that, I go to PCBWay. All my circuit boards that I've done in the past, all my Kickstarters that had electronics, I used PCBWay to fulfill the orders. I get great quality out of them. And you can go with other color solder masks. You don't have to go with green, but you get the full silk screen. You can go 2, 3, 4 layer boards. And they also offer 10 boards for $5. So check that out. So PCBWay, I highly recommend them. I use them all the time. To check out that $5 offer, just go to PCBWay.com. The 3018 CNC platform is so common, and the fact that it runs open source Gerbil firmware opens a lot of possibilities. There's various software that you can buy, both buy and get for free to run it. There's software for cutting circuit boards that I can show you in a future video. There's also all kinds of 3D prints to upgrade it, including mounts to put a stronger motor on it so you can cut thicker material. So there's a lot that you can do if you want to tinker with this machine. So if you're interested in that, let me know in the comments below. I'm pretty happy with this thing. For about, like I said, $350 for this machine, mostly assembled, it's not too bad. So if you think about getting a CNC, it might be something to check out. I'll put a link to this exact unit from SainSmart in the description below. If you like this, maybe check out some of the other CNC Sunday videos that are popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time.